All right. Maybe we should just start talking about Life is Strange.
Is swearing out of the question? Or
absolutely not.
Sweet.
Of course fucking swearing is out of the question.
I've got a lot of swearing in mind when it comes to talking about this game.
Dude, yes. Yes, there's so many.
I need far my first words.
I need all the curses. All of them.
I just need every single cuss there is to describe my feelings about this last episode.
Holy shit.
Oh my god.
There was nothing good that happened. My whole playthrough was depressing as fuck, and I felt
stressed out. What are you talking about?
Yeah, she got into the Vortex VIP. Yeah, that was good.
Fucking Warren laid the beat down.
Okay.
HG style.
Okay, you're right, but as soon as that happens, everything goes to shit after that. Literally everything.
Yeah, because that's when you learn that everything you thought up to that point is probably fucking wrong and that you're an idiot.
Yeah, but I think that's why I like this episode, though. Is because it's like, all the choices I was making had some impact here. Like, I was a bitch to, what's her name? Victoria, in the first episode. I took a picture of her and laughed at her when she got splattered with paint. And because of that, when I tried to warn her about Nathan, she didn't listen to me. Like, I tried to warn her, and she basically told me to fuck off.
I did the total nice route the whole way. The only thing I'm regretting right now, seriously, and I think I want to go back and change, is being a shithead to David, because now I'm thinking
he
knew about
all this.
See, I
was okay with David. I stuck up for David last episode.
What?
I'll tell you why.
You were mean to Victoria and you thought David was fine?
No, I'll tell you why. I never thought David was fine, but in terms of gameplay, I knew that since Chloe was a main character, she would quote-unquote forgive Max for not standing with her, but I knew that if I backstabbed David and didn't stick up for him, since he's a secondary or tertiary character, he probably would have an impact later on in the game. So I gamed it a little bit.
I wish I had that foresight. I was thinking completely different.
Because like I knew that Chloe, she's like they're best friends, and she's like the main character, basically, that you don't control. So I knew that they wouldn't do anything crazy where it's like, well, you stuck up for my dad that one time, so now I'm going to kill myself or something. Like, I knew that probably wouldn't happen.
It wasn't that. I just thought he was genuinely fucked up. So I was like, ew, get this guy out of here for their sake.
I mean,
gross.
I was thinking about it too simply.
He was fucked up.
Yeah, but now we know why. Now we know exactly who he was tracking, too.
I always felt a little bit bad for David, though, because one of the first things you learn about him is that he had PTSD. So, like, everything about him, I was just kind of like, well,
exactly.
He's fucked.
If I save this guy, right, he's going to come busting through a fucking window in one of these episodes and just shoot us both, and I'm fucked because I'm an idiot. Now I'm even bigger of an idiot because I didn't. Because
now
I
want him to go Marine on this asshole.
What if David is the only one that's going to save Max from where she's at right now? What if he's the only one and I just screwed it all?
See, what I'm thinking is that there's only a few points in this whole game and all the chapters where you're forced to take a selfie. And one of them is when you take a selfie with Warren before the party, like you enter the party. So I'm thinking she's going to time travel back to that point.
How?
Because she has
tied
it on
up.
Her.
She's hogtied, though.
I agree that she's probably going to do that. I am just super worried. Like, I am irrationally worried about what is going to happen between now
I am
and this
too.
Point. Like, I'm so scared.
How is this even gonna work out? The only person I was really nice to that could possibly come to our rescue but won't is Frank.
Oh, okay. So this is why I'm saying after you lay the beat down on Warren, fuck, man, it goes so bad. Because in my playthrough, Chloe fucking busts a cap in Frank's ass.
Oh, you didn't fix it? You let that happen?
I didn't rewind that. No, I let it play through. I was like, okay,
holy
let's
shit.
See where this goes.
I rewound that episode like 20 times to try to get it right. I'm like, no, there's gotta be. First, I shot his dog. Then I shot him in the head. I'm like, this is not the way this has to end.
See, I was kind of shocked by it. And after that, it just got worse and worse. So, like, I had the most depressing last half of that whole fucking episode.
Jeez.
I was stressed out the whole time.
Your shit went all wrong.
It's so bad. And then, like, I tried to be like, Victoria, listen to me. Like, watch out for Nathan, for the love of God. She's like, fuck off. You're an asshole.
That bitch ain't listening to you. You took a picture of her with paint all over.
I know, and that's why I'm like, oh no. Everything is crumbling. It was literally the end of the world happening. Oh man, it was.
I don't know. I think I did a bad with not being nice to David now. I'm not sure.
I think he might save. He might come into play anyway, potentially. But it might be more of like a, I don't know the word for it. It won't be like, I'm here to totally protect you two. It might be like, well, you know, this guy was bad, so I was just doing my job. No, fuck off.
Well, why wouldn't he? Because technically it's Chloe's dad now. Why wouldn't he protect them as the thing? And he's the one that's tracking everything. So I thought, fuck, that's who it probably needed to
even
be
said,
here,
man.
And he's not here.
Don't trust grown men with goatees. He knew.
I know.
Oh my god, you're right!
I still question exactly how much he knew. Like, I feel like he didn't suspect to the full extent what is going on, otherwise he would have done a bit more about it. Like, if the stuff that's happening...
I think he does know, and I think he just needs proof, because at first
probable
you think that he's tracking...
going on.
At first you think he's tracking what's-her-name. God, I always forget her freaking name, too. It's... No. The girl that tried to kill herself.
Kate.
Yeah, Kate. And then I think it's actually not...
Did you save her?
Oh, of course.
Yeah.
I did not.
What?
You didn't get that.
How did that
part
pan out?
In episode 4 where you talked to her then?
The first when I first played that episode and I went through and I was going through I thought I had reached a save point and I needed to take a break to do something quickly. And when I turned it back on, I hadn't reached that save point. So instead of clicking on everything like I did before, I just went through it. And I missed the Bible verse that would have saved her life. Like, I didn't know that the Bible verse was going to be key, so she ended up killing herself, which
I
made that episode
a lot more. I didn't save her with a Bible verse. I don't think I saved her with the picture of her sisters.
Yeah.
I didn't have that either.
Oh. So wait, were you missing an entire scene in episode 4? Because in episode 4, you go see her in the hospital. Was that just not there?
And she helps you out. She's like, I'll text you when I hear about Nathan.
Yeah, she texts you later and tells you what room Nathan's in. How did you figure that out?
Doesn't happen at all.
Yeah, none of that.
What?
How do we figure out what dorm is
Nathan's
in?
Dumb son, or whatever.
Well, yeah, I realize that, but I mean, you didn't also get the text is what I mean, which is weird.
Yeah, we didn't get the hospital scene at all. The end of that episode where she, for you, tried to kill herself, though, for us was, like, super emotional.
I bet.
Yeah,
it was a good ending.
Like, after that ending, they show everyone, and David's just, like, super... That's when I actually started feeling sorry for David, is because you see him feeling, like, seriously bad about it.
Yeah.
And, like, that's when you kind of realize, like, he's not just an ass.
Yeah.
And, yeah, I think Paul, you had mentioned you got that scene, too. But after she kills herself, it's just, I think, way more potent.
Yeah, probably. Actually, that reminds me, in that episode, after she kills herself and there's the whole, like, we gotta do something about this, so who do you want to blame for this incident or whatever, and you have three choices. Did anybody choose...
Blamed
Jefferson. Anybody.
No, but I wish I had now. I was wondering why he was even a person to blame, and now I'm like, oh, shit.
Okay.
They were handing it to you.
They even allowed you to blame him. Made me start rethinking.
Think at that point. I'm like, haha, that's just a troll answer to see if anyone's gonna go for it. And then I thought, well, they'll just yell at me and laugh if I say this, so I'm not gonna say it.
The reason I bring it
up
is because my girlfriend did choose that answer, and at the end there was like a creepy thing of him like looking through binders before it cut to black for that episode.
Oh, that would have totally set up everything.
And then you see the binders later.
Everyone. Yeah. I think I blamed everyone at the time.
Yeah, it was kind of everybody's fault. The only thing I ever suspected about Mr. Jefferson, honestly, was that I found it creepy that he took such interest in these, like, kids being a world-famous photographer. Like, I always thought he was creepy, but I never thought he was, like, that level creepy. I thought he was just maybe, like, trying to be the cool dad sort of thing. Like,
I didn't ever really think of him as coming off as creepy, to be honest. Now I'm kind of worried about what that says about the adults.
I'm very worried about, Victoria's fate now. She's hanging all over that dude like crazy. She's going to be next for sure.
Yeah. I mean, she has a binder ready for her and everything. So,
In hindsight, I think it kind of makes...
I warn her.
You what?
I successfully warned Victoria.
We warned her, but we warned her about Nathan. So what if Jefferson just comes out without him and she's going to be fucked that way?
In hindsight, I think it makes it, like, even more Victoria tried to sleep with Mr. Jefferson, basically, or, you know, just do whatever with him to get her photo selected or whatever it was. And he said no. Like, he declined that, but he still was targeting her.
I don't think it's a sexual thing. It's a predatory thing.
No, it's like a predatory thing.
It just makes it even worse at that point, because he doesn't want just, like,
he wants to control them. In the very beginning of the game, he has this monologue where he's talking about, like, dominance and capturing the moment of, like, despair on people's faces, or like emotion on people's faces. That's what he's talking about.
That's such a creepy line. Something about, like, I could put any of you into a dark corner and, like, capture you.
It didn't hit me until afterwards, and I remembered that scene, and I'm like, oh shit, there it is.
All the signs were there, every single one.
They were, and they hit them so well. I feel like such an idiot.
So in that regard, there's a theory going around, and I don't know if I necessarily agree with it, but I like to think about it, that Nathan is actually dead. That he was killed by Jefferson, maybe because they were targeting Victoria, and that he's, like, friends with Victoria and didn't want to, like, be a part of this one. So maybe Jefferson knocked
either
him off.
That, or I think he's drugged somewhere in the bunker, because the picture of him and Rachel Amber on the ground, he looks clearly fucked up. He doesn't look like he's even in it. And he's got all those problems that we learn about in this episode even more. I'm thinking Jefferson's just giving him the drugs to make him forget about it all.
Wait, like, dead recently, or dead, like, the whole time?
Recently, sort of, because nobody sees him again after he gets the shit kicked out of him.
Yeah.
I'm thinking he's drugged and hung up in the bunker. Like, he's
and Jefferson obviously has his phone, because Chloe gets a text from Nathan's phone.
Well, that's funny too, but the phone thing bothered me, and I'll tell you why. When you're going to Nathan's room and he had it purposely taped to the back of the couch, to me that doesn't seem right. Like, if you wanted to keep the phone away from people, you would probably have it on your person, because, like, Max and Chloe can't go up to him and get his phone off of his body. So it's just like, why did he do that? And then I had this huge theory that Jefferson was going into his room and taking the phone and using it and then putting it back. Like, that was the place where they put it.
I think he has burner phones, though, because he was dealing with drug dealers.
That could be, too.
See, I just want to know, like, Nathan and Mr. Jefferson had to be involved together somehow.
Absolutely. I agree with that.
Because of all the Prescott stuff in the barn, like...
I think Jefferson is a Prescott somehow.
Yeah, or somehow, or did something for them, or something to that effect. Because, I don't think he would just be able to be like, oh, Nathan, I see you have this nice little rape bunker. I'm going to use it now, or else. I just don't think that happened. Also, Nathan is insane anyway, so.
Did you see that picture in the barn that people colored over in Reddit? Like, you see that picture in the barn of, like, one of the old Prescotts or whatever, and somebody drew a beard on him, and it looks exactly like Mr. Jefferson.
Oh, yeah, shit. I'm thinking he's either an old Prescott and, like, just under a new alias, or heavily tied in with the family somehow. He must
be. Definitely.
He has to be. I mean, he's not Nathan's dad, like everyone's saying, because he's too young to be his dad. But, like, something's going on there.
Yeah, I don't think he's Nathan's dad at all. Maybe, like, an uncle or something. I don't know. Like, long-lost, removed brother. Who knows?
There's got to be some kind of family history there.
Yeah.
Episode 5 is going to be intense as shit.
Yes.
I don't even know if I should go back and replay, or if I should stay on this timeline and see it through and then go back and replay. I don't know what to do. I'm thinking I have to wait.
That's what I'm doing. I'm going to see it through and then... Try to see what else to do.
Stick with what you've done so far.
Yeah, I've definitely made some bad decisions that I wish I could do over, but...
See, my theory is that there's going to be multiple endings, and that's going to relate to the selfies that you have to take, the game forces you to take throughout the whole game, and there's, like, 4 points or something somebody pointed out. Like, one at the very beginning where Max is looking at the wall of photos, the one she takes in class that you have to take... Like, there's a bunch of different ones where the game just forces you to have them with you. So I'm wondering if maybe, like, there's a choice, like, I can go back in time and stop all of this, or like I could go to this alternate timeline or whatever. That alternate timeline, by the way, is fucking weird.
Let's just that, and I don't like how in every single like timeline that we've changed, Chloe has died in it, and when she dies the outcome is actually better than when she's lived. Do you notice that?
Yeah, like somehow someone, she has to die.
There was actually a thing going around about that. I think it was pre-episode 4 though. They were talking about how like Chloe repeatedly has been supposed to, like she's supposed to die, and it keeps not happening.
Yeah, there's like been theories going around that there's like some Final Destination shit going on where like every time Max saves Chloe, that's where the world gets weirder. Like that's where.
Yeah, it's the butterfly effect. Like everything's fucking up. She's only alive because Max keeps messing with time. And the death, I think, in the end of episode 4, I think that's fate just sealing it. Like it's trying to work out the knot. Like it has to go this way somehow. Mm-hmm. Some way, like, I hope that she comes back, but then
I do feel like the plot of the game is saving her.
Yeah,
I feel like that's a big part of it. Saving
I thought we were gonna save Rachel, but now apparently that's too late. So I wonder if we're ever gonna go back and actually see her alive or not. That's what I'm wondering.
So with that in mind, like with the alternate timeline things and like the world getting more fucked up every time you. Possible ending for the game. Yeah, it sounds right. This internet is trash. Do you think a possible ending for the game will be choosing between Chloe and the world?
I wouldn't put it past him.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah.
Or to some degree. Not necessarily one or the other, absolutely, but.
Or like between Chloe and Max, even.
Oh yeah, that's another one.
Yeah, that one.
Did anyone euthanize Chloe when she asked?
Absolutely,
I did.
You did? What? I couldn't either. What happened at the end? I want to know what I missed.
She basically says, "I'm proud of you." Dies, and then you look at a photo and travel back in time, and the game.
So it's the exact same. Nothing gets changed by doing that.
I guess so.
I don't think so.
No.
I was a little disappointed that such a huge and edgy choice had absolutely no effect. I mulled over that for a while. Like I was literally sitting and staring at that for like 10 minutes.
Yeah, I was talking to Peter when I came across it, and I didn't tell him what happened, obviously, because he's a little bit behind. But I was like, oh shit. Seriously? Like, this early in the game? Fuck.
It's like the first thing you do in that fucking game, too, in that episode.
She says when you get back that she can never talk to Chloe about it, but I really hope it comes up, because it would add so much. Like...
I think they're really going to be too busy.
I really want it to come up at some point, circle around, so it...
I feel like that whole moment is for... It's about, like, Max understand, like, getting more perspective on time travel stuff.
I guess,
fucked up how bad it can go and stuff.
Yeah, because she burns that picture, so she can never go back to that time and save her dad.
Yeah.
Like, after
that.
That
Chloe's dad was like... This one's a keeper, and then you just throw her into the fire.
Or the fact that she's like, oh shit, I need morphine, can you please go get it for me? And you spend 20 minutes looking at everything else.
Because you have to save the birds, man. You guys saving all the birds?
No.
I've missed
them. What?
Yeah, I've missed them.
I've been looking for them everywhere. Hopefully I've got them all. I don't know for sure, but they have to mean something. They have to.
Yeah, they might.
They mean
I started feeling like me saving birds was resulting in more birds dying in the backyard. When I started doing it, I just felt like that was what was happening.
What about Alyssa? I find it hilarious that she just keeps getting hit, punted, pushed in the pool. That
I
poor
totally
chick,
didn't
dude.
Save her from the pool. I didn't even notice.
What?
Afterwards.
Oh, dude, I laughed so hard when it first happened, and then
I didn't even notice
her
falling in or anything. I just walk up and it's like, oh, she's wet.
So I've saved her every time, and it's getting like weirder and weirder. Like your interactions with her are just fucking weird now.
Yeah, because she's just like, how the hell do you know this?
She's just like, why should I care about anything? You'll just save me.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. What if she like walks on into a fucking like, what if she walks onto a highway later or something because she just doesn't care anymore and we did that.
It's okay. Max will save me.
Yeah. Oh my god.
I actually like Alyssa. I like all those interactions. I look forward to every episode seeing like what dumb thing she gets hit with.
She's hilarious.
Do you guys talk to what's his name? Like that kind of that guy leaning up against a tree that was like all depressed.
Oh, the drawing guy? The guy with the art?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, like the dude that's on Drew. Like, what do they call him? Like a fat hipster or something like that?
Yeah, the Mexican guy. No offense.
Sure, yeah. I didn't realize that was a thing until after. I'm like, oh, I suppose I could have like convinced him to go. Maybe he could have helped me.
I didn't convince him to go. He would have just been made fun of the entire time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Did anybody else realize or notice that you like in the alternate timeline she talks about the only real friend I had or whatever after you left was Megan, and there's a binder for Megan in the normal timeline? That she's been in that dark room. It's weird, man. It's creepy.
There's a what?
There's a Megan binder.
You cut out after you said alternate timeline for
in
me.
The Megan, in the alternate
timeline. I couldn't figure out who Megan was.
In the alternate timeline, Chloe's only friend that talked to her was named Megan after her accident or whatever. And Megan is one of the like victims or whatever of Jefferson.
You're right.
There's a binder
you're
for
right.
her. It's weird. Mm. That's creepy, man. I don't like it. Makes me feel icky.
Yeah. God, that...
And then there was the note in the bunker that was clearly written by Jefferson.
For sure, yeah.
And not Nathan's dad.
Which was?
It was the one that was like, I told you never to call me, like... by my real name again. I've been giving you disposable phones just for this reason. That one. Let me see if I can find a picture.
Yeah, it ends off with something like something about like him.
I put it in the chat.
There it is. Yeah, we can accomplish it a lot together, but you have to let me guide you. Like, I don't know. There's so much creepy shit, man.
Well, there's also that thing in episode 2 when Max talks to him about Kate and he kind of brushes her off. Do you remember that?
Yeah.
And then he gets a phone call and has to take it. And when he gets to like the end, if you follow him, you can clearly see that he's a little bit agitated, like on the phone.
I did sit there while he was on that call.
Yeah, I think that's kind of a giveaway. And I didn't even realize it about that, how he's probably talking to Nathan and how he fucked up, like where Nathan was freaking out.
I didn't even put that together. Yeah. Huh.
It took me a while. I've literally like been up thinking about this like every night. The Reddit is really good, too. The subreddit for this, if you guys read it, it's super good.
Oh, yeah. Like, the day after, I had to work, and I spent 3 hours at work just seeing every new post that came up. There's so many things, man. There's so many things in this game. But the worst thing, still, is not even necessarily that Chloe gets shot again, because, like, we've seen her get shot a few times now. Just when it shows her lifeless body there. Like, as it's panning away, and there's just, like, a
like, on top of where Rachel is.
It's so
awful.
It's fucking haunting. It is the worst thing I've seen in a game in a while.
Dude, I didn't like it. Like, when they were digging Rachel up, I seriously felt like I wanted to throw up. Just the voice acting through that scene was really good.
Yeah.
And, like,
like, you can pinpoint the minute they realize it's Rachel, and, like, her heart broke. It's terrible.
I hope they're wrong. I don't think they're wrong. So everyone's saying, oh, it's not Rachel. They just made it to seem that way to set them up. I don't know.
I kind of feel that way too, because
they didn't show enough for us to really understand.
Yeah.
Yeah, especially in this game. Kind of hoping for another twist like that, but I don't know if we'll get it.
There's a theory going around that Samuel the janitor is actually hiding Rachel from Jefferson and everybody.
Yeah, because I remember...
He had something that had to do with her.
He had her scarf and her fashion magazines in his shed in episode 2.
I didn't even realize.
I don't think he's hiding it from Jefferson, but maybe in collaboration.
Yeah, I was going to say,
They mentioned specifically the junkyard, and Jefferson's there.
So
So it's not like he's...
That's another thing. You just talk to him at the party, and then you freaking go to the graveyard. How'd he get there so goddamn fast without you noticing?
Adult speed.
The power of editing.
He's literally talking on a microphone while you're on the way there. Tell me how he got there that
Especially,
fast.
Like, we've seen how Chloe drives. There's no way anybody's beating her to that location.
Yeah, but if he got there and he knew where to go...
It had to be that. Maybe they're implying that you... Yeah, maybe you're implying that you looked around the place for a long time. I didn't have the nerve to look around anywhere in the dark.
I didn't understand why they were walking around with a giant ass light. Like, I'm gonna keep that.
I mean, because gameplay, honestly, because it would. We can see in the dark in person, but when you try to convey a dark space in a video game, it's hard.
I missed out on that writing on the wall that says you're all gonna die because I was too scared to, like, look through anything in that dark. I was so freaked that
someone
was gonna be there ready to shoot.
I'm actually with you. I stuck with Chloe because she had the gun.
I did. I did not want to go anywhere. I might have missed the deer showing up again. I don't know. I might have missed, like...
But then I
saw the picture of it, and I'm like, oh, shit.
Did you see that data mined picture of, like, when you turn the camera in the cutscene where Jefferson's sneaking up on Max? It's the most fucking terrifying thing. So
what are you talking about?
You can go into, like, developer mode or something in that game, and you can move the camera in the cutscene where they find Rachel, and you can see Jefferson slowly sneaking up on Max with his gun out and a needle in his hand.
What? Do you have that photo? I need to see it.
I will find it, yeah.
Yay! Yeah, when Chloe got shot for this third time, it was then that I realized that she has to die.
She can't die because her and Max need to end up together.
But there's, like, I think she's, like, the binder that has, like, she's the thing that has to happen for any of these time alterations to actually occur. Like, it's the price that has to be paid when you're altering time so much, because it just keeps happening. Even in the one where her father lives, she still dies. You know what I mean? It's just like, you can't win. It was at then where I'm like, this is just time telling us that she has to fucking die for this to occur. And because it's not, that's why all the weird echo shit is happening. The world's, like, literally turning in on itself. I don't know.
I definitely agree that this was, like, far more stressful than any horror game I played. Like, it was just the worst feeling the whole
Without
time.
Without a doubt. And it's because they let you, like, build up a relationship with the characters. Like, you want to care about these characters so much that when bad shit happens to them, it's, like, really, really bad for you as a player. Whereas in video games, it's kind of like, I don't really care that I'm a security guard. I don't care if this dude dies. I just don't want to be scared by the jump scare.
Yeah. I don't know. These guys are doing really good, and I really hope they continue to do good things. Like, I don't want this to be a one-off game for them.
I know. I want them to make more. So good.
Seems like it's doing pretty well, and I can't imagine the expectations on it were super high.
Yeah. It kind of came out of nowhere, didn't it?
Well, I think everyone compares it to that other one that actually haven't played. What's it called? The Wolf Among Us or something?
Oh.
Did they make that one?
No.
That's Telltale.
Right. The team that made this game, the game they made before, was Remember Me.
Yeah.
Which was more standard.
Oh, right.
Type stuff. With a female protagonist.
That got It got mediocre reviews, but I've been talking about this with Peter, and I think maybe I mentioned it when I was talking to you, Paul. Remember Me apparently got a lot of praise for a really great story, but it had combat and stuff in it, which was kind of, like, meh. Like, it was...
From what I've heard, it has, like, standard AAA, not big enough budget, issues where it's not long enough, it's not, like, deep enough mechanically, even though it had some interesting ideas.
Oh, you're talking about Remember Me?
Yeah.
I never played it.
I want to check out the story now, though.
But isn't The Wolf Among Us a game like this, where it's like an adventure where you make decisions, or am I wrong?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, this game is following sort of in the
I think a lot of people are comparing it to that. Yeah.
This is better, though.
This is better, for sure, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, because I don't like those games, and I like it.
That's what I want to know. Is Wolf Among Us still good? Like, is that a good game? I don't know.
Wolf Among Us is, of all the Telltale stuff, that's the one I would recommend.
That's one of the best, yeah.
Because what makes that one stand out is in the The Walking Dead and stuff, a lot of their choices just come down to binary, like choosing if people are going to live or die.
I'm really sick of
that. It gives you a little more just flavorful choices.
I have the Game of Thrones one, and I'm a huge Game of Thrones fan, but I didn't like the game. I didn't like how it played. I didn't like any of it. So
yeah, the Game of Thrones one is pretty mediocre.
One of my friends was a while back was trying to get me to play the Walking Dead games. First games in a long time to actually make me like feel stuff and, you know, be sad and actually feel for the characters and everything. I'm like, yeah, but zombies, I'm out. Like, straight up.
I'm so sick of zombies.
And she was going on about how good it was in the story and everything. And I'm like, yeah, that's fine. Like, that's really cool. I'm glad that it's doing this for you, but I'm just not going to bother because, honestly, zombies. And then this game came out, and I'm like, hey, you said you really like games that make people feel and, like, you know, stir emotions up. Maybe play this game. She's like, nah. I'm like, just it? Like, I at least had zombies as an excuse because, but just nah. I'm like, come on, just do it. It's so good.
Oh my god, I got so many stupid theories about this fucking game. Been up for days thinking about them.
Well, David's gonna save the day, right? Like, we're all sure of that, because before...
No,
I think so,
somebody's going to.
Not in my game.
Okay.
Somebody's going to.
The reason I bring this up, though, is that before you go out, like, to the final stuff or whatever, Chloe, there's a shot as they're leaving Chloe's bedroom of, like, she left up the page of the coordinates of where Rachel was buried. On her computer.
And they did go out of their way to show that another gun is missing from the gun rack.
Yes, exactly.
Yes.
Oh, God!
So he's definitely armed.
He's definitely armed, he has PTSD, he's a Marine, he's gonna kill that motherfucker.
Man. If there's another bluebird in the last episode and it's dead and you can't do anything, then my theory about those damn birds are correct, and I can't wait to see if my theory is correct. Because every episode, Chloe is set to die, and you have to save her. And in every episode so far, we've seen a blue bird that we have to save in some way. And it's just like, it's blue. It's the same color as her hair, man. Am I going crazy thinking about this? I could have PTSD right now, for all I know, because of this goddamn thing.
Life is Strange gave me PTSD.
Should sue. Can't get any sleep.
I really like that at the end of each episode, they give you a phone number for a helpline in case you're dealing with real life problems and this triggered off any of those. Like,
yeah,
it's pretty, actually cool.
It's actually really thoughtful because, like, the whole suicide thing, there was a suicide prevention line, like, given to you right after. And, like, every episode, see, they've given it to you for bullying and stuff like that. Like,
see, I was talking to someone, like, normally I really dislike all the trigger warning bullshit, but this game actually warrants it.
Yes,
like,
it does.
It's
serious, realistic.
It totally does.
It's too realistic in, like, everyday shit you have to deal with bullying and
especially
the pressure.
Like, the fact that you can look through some of...
You cut out.
Some of the what?
That's so dark. It's so dark.
you cut out, Ben. All we heard was, that's so dark.
You can look through some of the...
I mean, the photos, the binder.
Paul, did you find that picture?
Oh, yeah.
I'm still looking. There's so much on this subreddit.
I need to not sleep tonight at
There's
all.
There's so much on this subreddit. Okay, so, like, there was some... the funniest thing I read on this subreddit is, like, how the game should end in episode 5. And it's basically like Max shoots Mr. Jefferson, takes a picture of his corpse, goes back in time, hands it in for the everyday photos contest. And when Mr. Jefferson's like, what the fuck is this? Basically, she's just like, life is strange, and walks away. Credits. And I was just like, that's the best ending ever. I do think she's going to go back in time to the everyday Heroes contest beginning or something.
That'd be cool.
What's this?
This was left in the game when they rolled out the episode 3 update, and it's an early version of that very last cutscene in episode 4 when he's preparing the syringe.
Mm-hmm.
And I had no fucking clue what this was.
Looking at it.
Another creepy thing is that the first time I went to the junkyard and was like looking around, one of the things you find on the ground are syringes, and I thought it was maybe just from junkies, and now I know, man.
Yeah, I thought it was just drugs.
Oh, shit.
Wait, so this was supposed to be the end of episode 3?
No. This was a video that they left in the files when episode 3 rolled out.
Yeah, I remember you showing me that. Crazy.
Well, that's clearly Jefferson. Clearly.
It's so creepy.
Yeah.
It is creepy.
If anyone I know ever, like, after I'm like, I don't know.
If anyone ever drugs me in the middle of the woods, I'll be very cross.
No, any of my guy friends are like, you know, I should grow a goatee, man. I'll be like, no, don't do it. Don't do it, please. Don't. No, I didn't know you were like this.
I didn't know you were like this.
Don't be like this, please.
Don't be a Jefferson. Be a David.
Just immediately report them to the police.
Please tell me that they're going to release episode 5 on October 11th, because isn't that the day the tornado started? Didn't they give you a date on that?
That sounds familiar.
I think so.
Hmm.
They might be. Maybe they planned that from the beginning. Last episode on the...
That'd be amazing.
That would be pretty good.
Although I want it in September, so please don't make us wait.
Yeah, I kind of just
want
it
now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, as much as I do want them now, like, seeing Telltale's releases, like, that they take the 2 months to release every episode is good, because it makes the game better. Than if they were releasing them quicker.
Oh, shit.
Is that just a photo? Is that a moving picture? Am I going to get screamed? Oh, no, it's a JPEG. All right, we're good.
This is a JPEG. There's another one I'm looking for. There's two. There's that one and then one of him, like, right behind her with the needle out.
So you can't pan your camera at all during that cutscene to see this, right?
No, not unless you go into, like, the developer mode or whatever to do it. Which is kind of cool, because, like, obviously the cutscenes, like, they animated all that stuff with in-game assets and then just made them into cutscenes. So the fact that they did that, that can lead to creepy shit like this, where you can see him coming up on her, and it's so fucking bad. I hate it.
That's creepy, dude.
Fucking game.
So am I the only one wondering if Jefferson also has time travel abilities, or no?
Peter brought that up. The other day, asking me. I don't think he does.
I don't think he
does.
How
the hell, then, is he in all these places at the right time, and then getting, like, at least 20 people that he's amassed in his picture collection?
Maybe Peter can elaborate.
I was suspecting that Rachel Amber had time travel powers, just because of the way people talked about her always being perfect and showing up everywhere and knowing everyone.
That's right. Rachel's spirit is obviously related to the deer, right? Because it keeps showing up in all these bad places.
And it disappeared. It disappeared, man. It was so bad.
Yeah,
and it, like, hung its head down low when they found her. Like, she was sad about it.
I hate that a video game is actually making me care about anything in it.
Me talking about this and then telling John that I was going to talk about it with you has made him want to play it. I'm so excited.
Is he actually going to?
Yeah, oh yeah, he really wants to now.
But he doesn't have any feelings. He's just going to
Well, maybe he will after that. No, you know what? He ruins this for me every time. Every time I play a game that has these kind of emotions and I didn't like, he'll play it and he'll pick it up. He'll pick up right away, like in episode 1 that it's Jefferson. He'll be like, that guy did it. He does this every time.
Every time.
I'm hoping he doesn't. I actually just want to see the choices that he makes. I want to see if he's going to be a dick or if he's going to, like, see through it.
Peter, Ben was saying that you have a theory that Jefferson is also a time traveler or something.
Yeah, it is a very flimsy theory. I sent him, you know, I sent him a really bored text. I was like, what if Jefferson had time travel? Like, I was bored. What if he had time travel powers?
He showed up, right? He was already there, poised to strike them. He was talking on the damn microphone as they were going.
Like,
come on.
It's like teleportation, though.
Well, but Max can do that. Like, she can put herself in another place just by rewinding time. And then it doesn't seem like any time has moved and she's in a new place.
Like, I don't even know how that'd work out from our perspective of the timeline, but if he, like, saw them there and then time-traveled back while he was standing in the right spot.
See, when she time-traveled through the photograph, she jumped into her old body. It's not like there was a dupe of her.
I'm still wondering, too, about the two moons and why they fade at the end. I don't get it.
Did you also notice that in the barn, when you're rewinding time, you see, like, the ghost of the other Max at the same time that you're doing shit?
Yes, that I did notice.
Because that didn't happen before. That only started happening.
Did it not happen before?
It didn't.
Because I thought that maybe I just missed it the whole time before. Now I'm going to have to go back and see that again.
I'm pretty sure it didn't happen before.
Actually, we should compare. What if it's something that they've, like, been making more note, like, if the ghost was less visible in early episodes and now they've just increased the opacity sort of deal?
Maybe.
And now it's becoming more...
Well, we've always seen the people go back, but never her. She's always in one place. And then I thought, oh, crap, did I just miss it? Or maybe has she split time into almost two and they're kind of, like, over each other?
Someone pointed out, and I haven't actually checked, but I assume it sounds like something that is true, that every time you do one of your big time travel things and you're in Chloe's car, the writing inside of it changes. Like, all the drawings on it change.
Yeah, also, when you go back to the normal timeline or whatever, and you look out the window and she says, like, at least the view hasn't changed. It actually has, because the billboard says something completely different.
Yeah.
Than the first time you go to her house. So even, like, when you jump back and then you jump back to the normal timeline, something had changed from the first time you were there. And that was, like, the first clue of that. And it's really, really weird and disconcerting that, like, we probably fucked everything up by doing that one jump to help save her father.
Well, that one jump, or even just, like, you know, extreme butterfly effect, like, you said those things that you wouldn't have normally said, and you burned that picture, and that somehow, you know.
Yeah. I hate when games have theories, like, that you can just conjure up out of every little thing. Like, what did the ladybug on the clock mean? There was a ladybug on the clock, man.
I am so sick that I wasn't nice to David now, because the more I think about it, the more I fucked up. God damn it. It was too easy. I shouldn't have given in to such easy accusations at first. Should have known.
Yeah, like, as soon as episode 4 ended, I'm like, I want David back.
Yeah, he was the least of our problems. Because when you go into the bunker, right, it's a bunker that's, like, designed for a natural disaster at first, clearly, before you get to the dark room stuff. And then Nathan says sometime, he's like, be careful, a storm's coming. And you think it's just an idle threat, like, it's just a way of threatening you. But then, now that I'm remembering, David also had, like, a supply closet, like, full of stuff for, like, an apocalypse.
Yeah.
And, like, in that episode, we learned that he was, like, doing work for the Prescotts as well. Like, that he's helped them out. Do you remember that?
Yeah.
Like, he did surveillance work for them at one point or something?
Yeah, like, he has plans in his thing or whatever of setting up cameras in their estate.
So he was trying to infiltrate and figure out what was going on. So he knows about something? At least,
I think everybody in that town, when you talk to them, suspects that the Prescotts are, like, really bad. Not just bad business people, but, like, just bad people in general. So he's probably one of those. The only difference is, with the PTSD and being a Marine, like, everybody's an enemy when you have that accusation. So he goes to the extreme, and maybe for the better in this case.
Also, I want to know if Rachel was the only one that actually died. And if she is one of the only girls that actually died, why?
There is a theory on that too, that like because she was into the party scene and like hanging out with Frank and probably did some drugs, that the what they drugged her with didn't take full effect right away, so they got nervous, drugged her more, and then she overdosed.
Yeah, because there's that. She's the one that she's the only one that has the picture where she's like awake and looking super ass mad.
Exactly. Yeah. Like everybody else is knocked out completely, and she's the only one that, in like her fucked up photo, is like somewhat coherent.
That would also correlate with the date that they needed more drugs, like in a super hurry. But I thought that was the date for Kate and not Rachel. So maybe I'm wrong about that. I'm gonna have to go research that.
I find it really that text that Max sends to Nathan really weird in the alternate timeline about how she's in the dark room.
Yeah, when I saw that,
I got
scared. I was so freaked out.
There's weird shit going on. There's some really bad shit going on.
Real bad.
Ugh. Oh. I can't handle it, my poor heart.
I mean, theoretically, in the alternate timeline, there was none of that bad stuff going on.
Maybe because Max was in on it, though. She told Nathan she's in the dark room working on her Everyday Heroes project.
What's that from? Like, when did that show up? I don't remember ever seeing that.
In the alternate timeline, in her text. Timeline.
Yeah, if you scroll back.
Because Nathan texts her saying, like, you come into the two whales or whatever, and she's
when
like...
When she was talking to Chloe? Is that, like, when she was visiting Chloe? Is that when she got it?
Yeah, like, in that alternate timeline. I missed it somehow. Yeah.
It's... But the school also clearly has a dark room also, right?
Probably,
I would think
I would assume so, yeah.
Yeah.
photography section of the school. No,
like,
dark.
All you just literally need a closet with like no window.
Or is Samuel's room where people think Rachel is hiding is the dark room? Who knows? I don't know. Maybe Nathan knows she's there if she is there.
There's another theory that Samuel doesn't like travel through time, but he can see the future in his dreams going around.
He's an odd one, so I wouldn't put it past him.
Yeah.
He knows way too
much. I cleaned up another dead bird's nest in the yard today.
You're so creepy. It's so...
I feel better about this.
Yeah. Talking about it, our support group.
It's one of those problems, though, where it's like... No, I want everybody I know to play this at the exact same time as me, so we could talk about it exactly after.
We should have like a giant multi-stream where we're just like all playing it at the exact same time somehow.
I think what I'm gonna do when episode 5 comes out is do all 4 before 5 comes out in a row live to catch everybody up that wanted to watch maybe at some point.
Yeah, I would like to stream it as well. I don't think doing YouTube for it would be good, but I would like to stream it.
Yeah.
I think I might be able to convince Bruce. Bruce is kind of on the edge of getting it. I might be able
Who's
to convince
Bruce?
Him too. Yeah. He's that guy from a while back.
Yeah.
You know, in the olden days.
The olden days. Simpler the times. Days.
The olden days. Simpler times.
I don't know. I'm more leaning towards the fact that maybe Rachel had time travel powers of some kind, like someone else said, because she's gone, and now Max is here with the same powers, and she's kind of becoming the same thing. Like, because by the party, you're pretty much, if you did certain things, you're like friends with everybody, even like the people that hated you before.
No,
wasn't that like Rachel's thing?
Everybody hated me at that party. Everybody.
Well, then you didn't make the right choices because I was like the most popular person at the party. I'm telling you right now.
I made the right choices because I stuck with what I believed in. I didn't give in to peer pressure.
That's peer pressure to take a picture of someone with paint all over themselves. So mean.
I was so glad that happened. Like, okay, let's all be honest here, though. When Nathan was getting, like, his ass beat by Warren, who actually stopped them?
I didn't. I thought it was great.
Nah. I stopped him.
You did?
I stopped him.
Yeah.
What?
I did.
Come
no,
on,
I didn't
man.
Do that. I let him get it.
The guy who's scribbling insane notes in a notebook and is clearly some form of psychotic and has a gun. Yeah, well, let's let someone kick the shit.
That, and because I took it, I thought personally that he was the one that ran over Chloe in the additional timeline and caused her to... Because she specifically says SUV, and everyone talks about his goddamn SUV, and I'm like, oh god, okay, Nathan ran her over. Okay, I'm gonna kill him now.
Because
of giving a shit about Nathan. I just didn't want Warren to be doing that. Like, what? It was to save him from himself.
Ben,
you missed out on double gun. I got two guns.
Yeah.
So good.
I will concede, though. There's a point where, like, when you let Warren go, I wanted to stop him because it got too far. Like, there's like a whole 2 minutes of him beating the fuck out of him. Like, it was actually brutal. Like, it's like, okay, he's down, he's crying, like, you can stop punching his face in. Oh no, you're gonna go for another 30 seconds? Okay.
Shit.
It was real bad.
Yeah, like, I didn't want Warren to do that.
Yeah. And then he still goes in for the alpha comment. I feel pretty alpha right now.
Oh, that was the worst.
So bad.
He says that even if you stop him.
Yeah, he said, yeah, that's, regardless.
It's too bad, too, because I really like Warren. Or did. Anyways, until he opens his goddamn mouth.
I was going to say he's still fine. In our timeline, he's still fine, I think. Because you stop him and he's like, yeah, I shouldn't have done that, like... Thank you. In your timeline, he probably thinks he's a piece of shit, up. So good job on that.
He gets pretty drunk later, too.
Yeah, he gets hammered.
He gets hammered, and he still doesn't have the balls to really hit on Max.
No, because he's taking that Asian girl to the drive-in, right? She can't stop fucking talking about it. All three dialogues.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry. All three dialogues with her, how she's going to the damn drive-in.
What the fuck is up with her voice actor, though?
I don't know. She sounds so awful.
So weird.
I wish I could have punched her in the face instead. I didn't like her at all.
Oh, man.
I'm happy for them, though. She's obviously stoked to be going out with him, so...
Are you okay with that, Max?
Yeah.
Or she's just trying to be a bitch to Max.
No, bitch, I'm not okay with this. Stop talking about it.
Yeah, I'm totally okay with it. Why do you keep...
Oh, okay, let me talk about it for 30 more minutes.
Give me your fucking drone and go.
Why are you talking about this date so much? Is he like your beard or something?
She was majorly boner.
Do you know what that term means, Paul?
I do, yeah.
Okay, just
it doesn't.
Sure.
Yeah.
It applies. Is there some sort of woman term I'm missing? Is there like.
Yeah, that's why we give you so much shit on a daily basis. Shit like this.
Peter, just go back to fucking drinking syrup or whatever it is you do.
Yeah.
Setting factories on fire.
Yeah.
What I'm going to have to figure out is how to be nice to David and still save Kate. Because I feel like in the way beginning, if you don't side with Kate enough, you won't have a chance to save her. So I'm going to have to I don't want to fuck it up again, man. This whole thing now revolves around David.
Just go back to episode 3 and stick up for him instead. And then
do you think just that'll do it? If maybe. I did that?
I don't think it matters, honestly, because he knows something's up, and whether or not you're nice to him, he's going to kick some ass, I think.
Yeah.
Especially when he finds out that his daughter got shot in the face. Like,
stepdaughter, but yeah, same thing.
I can't wait to see how it ends, honestly. I need to know.
Oh my god. Like, at first I was kind of hesitant about the whole episodic thing, but now I'm really glad they did it, because that's just building everything up so much more, and it's really nice, in a way.
It's been funny, too, because it's like, every single person that I've just, like, been, after you finish episode 4, you have to say something to me. And, like, I'll just randomly get these messages every now and then on Twitter, like, in DMs, like, what the fuck? Yeah.
I saved the wrong person. Why? I let Frank live, of all people, and he's not going to come back, because the fact that you could have killed him means that he's probably not going to have a huge bearing on episode 5. And then, I sent David away like a fool.
Or maybe it's my interaction with Frank, I couldn't get it to a point where no one got hurt. The closest I got, like, before just being like, okay, whatever, this is it, was just stabbing him in the leg.
You have to tell her to not have the gun. You have to shut the door.
No,
so
I actually
the dog that, comes out.
I
dog
got
doesn't
it
out.
With her having the gun.
Did you?
Yes. I told her she had to shut her mouth.
Yeah, shut her mouth.
It's like, because we'd gone through
See,
it twice with her having
things.
Shot him, and I'm like, all right.
I got it with shutting the door and not having the gun.
No,
I wonder
and talking,
been...
and talking about Rachel's picture made him calm down. Like, that was the one that didn't trigger him.
No, the key for me was talking about how he rescued dogs.
Yep.
Like,
I did that, but then you have to talk about something that has to do with Rachel. Then he gets real mad.
No, I just kept him calm. Like, he just never got mad. So then she never had to use the gun.
I wonder if it would have been easier if you had... Did any of you kill his dog?
No.
You could let it run into the street? I wonder if it would have been easier if you would have done that, because then he would have been, like, kind of depressed from that.
Maybe.
I think he would have come after you, or you would have been
probably,
in more trouble.
You would have been more easily agitated, probably.
I don't know. I guess
because that whole conversation is like about keeping him from not flipping out, because he's really close to just
kind of. Yeah, it kind of revolves around his dog and how he rescued the dog, right? So if he didn't have the dog there,
he didn't talk about rescuing the dog at all.
Well, you fucked up.
The one that
you guys
like,
do. What did you guys do with him that I didn't? Because he was pissed off the entire time, like, throughout the entire conversation.
Ben, like, do you have social skills, or...?
What I found interesting is that he would... If you say things that you shouldn't know about, he gets so fucking mad. And that just makes me think about, like, of, like, the ways in which certain people, like, David is crazy. I just wonder if it's because of past time travel stuff just made him more and more paranoid. Like, I feel like there was time travel going on before Max got it. It's, like, the big thing.
Really?
For how fucked up this town is.
Could
because
be.
Just from what you've done, it shouldn't affect... quite so much, it feels like. With the obvious exception when you go back super far.
So, on a lighter note, I don't mean Peter noticed. did you guys notice that there was a lot...
You cut,
cut out.
Oh, he's time traveling. Stop him!
It's hella late.
He just smoked some dank OG weed. Tell me you guys got that line.
Yep.
Please, it's the best line ever.
It's pretty
Wait,
good.
That's not a photo to time travel through. That's a dank meme. Don't look at it.
He's like, yo, I just smoked some dank OG weed. I don't know, man.
Oh my god, so good. So stupid.
What were you saying about a lighter note, though? Please, anything right
no,
now
like,
to grasp onto.
No, like, no, in the episode, like, there was so many more memes. Like, there was that thing on the outside of the school.
Oh, I remember that.
Why the you play hard to get when you already hard to want?
The are you know.
No.
Why you know.
Or I can has art now. And I think, yeah, Warren was wearing, like, the, not Lenny face, but one of those shirts.
What shirts?
Like, they just... I don't know what it was. They went full Borderlands 2 on it.
Borderlands 2 doesn't slap on a Why You Know image on the wall.
Yeah, but they did double rainbow.
Yeah, but... it's different.
I guess.
Let's tell you.
So who here thinks Chloe has to die in the end of the game? Like, that she's just going to be dead?
Unfortunately, I think it's going to have
that
to be that way.
I don't
Is
think
there
that
a difference
all.
Between her having to die and whether she does die or not?
No, I mean having to die as in, like... Well, there's probably going to be a multiple ending thing, I think. Like, save the world or save the girl thing, I'm thinking. And
save
I'll prob- I'll probably, like, let Chloe die to make sure everything else is okay.
Yeah, I could see that, like, being the, you have to sacrifice Chloe to save everything else or put it back as it should be.
What if this is all just a coma dream, though? That Max is just, like, working out her guilt for not visiting her friend as she's on her deathbed.
Then we're in Mario 2.
Or Driver San Francisco.
Or Lost? Wasn't Lost sort of a...
Wasn't Lost because of,
Lost did
Wasn't
the
Lost because
thing.
Of the Bermuda Triangle?
No, they were, wasn't, weren't they in, like, fucking limbo or something, and the island was, like, testing them to go to heaven or hell or some bull?
Oh, yeah. That's not a coma, that's limbo. That's purgatory.
No, it was one of those shit, it's all a dream ending sort of deal.
That's not purgatory, it's not a dream.
It's the same thing.
It's like an actual struggle between good and evil.
No, not really. Nah. Limbo is actually the opposite of a struggle between good and evil. It's a nice happy medium.
Yeah, but it's not a dream.
Okay.
It's still sort of a
limbo.
On a better note, then, who thinks Jefferson dies?
I hope.
If there is an ending where he lives and triumphs, I feel really sad for those people that get that ending.
I don't see a way where Max gets out of that situation and he lives.
Yeah, but I could see a more time-traveled, changed timeline where he's not a psychopath possible.
Hmm.
But I think in this timeline, he's got to die.
He's got to
go. Did we even see him in the alternate timeline?
No.
No, you don't see him at all.
Okay.
So, like, do you think alternate timelines will be part of the ending? Like, maybe you can choose to go, like, Chloe's in a wheelchair or whatever, but you're happy with friends because you're popular in that timeline, or you stay in this one, Chloe's dead, but and you're kind of an outcast, but things are kind of the way they should be.
I don't know about that. I think, like you guys said, there is a setup for it.
It's not going to be, like, super happy ending. There's going to be some compromise, but...
Yeah, I don't think there's going to be a true happy ending. Not at this...
Has anybody here played through Remember Me?
No. It was something about a car crash, if I remember.
I think in other games, I might consider, like, anything, like...
You cut out.
True happy ending? Yeah, that sounds right. Because of, like, how connected you feel to everyone and everything, like, just the fact that the events that have taken place, it's not going to feel true happy. Like, even if everything's all good, it's like all this shit still happened to those people, and I still feel so bad about it.
I kind of expect an ending where time travel stuff happens so that no one remembers time traveling, who's left happening at all.
What if, like, Max time travels, points a finger at Jefferson, and then just, like, kills herself so she can't change anything else ever again?
Who thinks Nathan's dead? Because I do. I definitely think
I think
he's
Nathan's
dead.
Like, if he's not dead, he's completely incapacitated somewhere and might as well be dead.
He got the letter in his room from his father about not fucking up anymore, right? Because he fucked up real bad with Kate. And then when you go into the dark room, his jacket's there, but he's not.
It's not necessarily there, by the way. It depends on what happens with the fight. If you pull him away, apparently there's a chance it won't show up there.
Really?
I found it weird, too.
Ooh, then maybe the fight got him killed. That was, like, the last stupid thing. Oh, God, maybe I got him killed.
I kind
Holy
of
shit.
Hope I did.
At what point?
I didn't know that the jacket didn't show up.
Okay.
If you stopped Warren from beating him up.
For you guys who stopped the fight, did you see Nathan's jacket in the dark room on the chair?
I wasn't looking for it, so I don't honestly don't
you
know.
Would have
seen it.
I saw the jacket in
the It's
dark
his Letterman room, yeah. jacket on the stark white couch that was in there.
And there's like a thing that pops up when you walk by to look at it.
Yeah,
like
it's very obvious.
It.
Yeah, I noticed it, and I stopped the fight, so.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Okay, huh. There's images on Reddit that show, like, the jacket's not there for...
I wonder
that
what...
That must have been a different connection.
I wonder what that choice would have been. I think in mine, I think because the jacket's there, I think he's dead. For sure.
I agree.
I think Jefferson did the thing. Said his little speech, and then did the thing again.
And I think it's because he wouldn't do it to Victoria. He actually considered her a friend. Which is kind of even more sad that he, like, had
Wait,
humanity.
Who?
I think
Jefferson?
I think the reason why Nathan might be dead is because he didn't want to get Victoria.
Oh,
I could see that going down.
I could,
like,
see that.
Tells Jefferson not to do anything to Victoria, or he'll rat him out. That's an easy path to death.
Yep. So there's a theory that Nathan's dead, and that's his body in that grave.
But then, like, Jefferson must be confident about not being caught or not having any connection to that, because.
Yeah.
His family's pretty powerful, right?
Yeah. I would think
so. As much as Nathan's dad gives him shit, I'm sure he rolls up dead one day. He'll be pretty angry.
The fact that the police for the city are in the Prescott pocket, yeah, they're pretty powerful.
Yeah.
I'm trying to think of, for the timeline in this episode, like, when did you visit Rachel versus when did Nathan stop appearing?
You never meet Rachel.
Or not meet Rachel, but find her. Supposedly her.
You do not see Nathan at all after the confrontation with Warren in the dorm rooms. Period. Okay.
Yeah, so what happens is that fight happens, you go back to, you do a bunch of other stuff, and then you find the grave.
And I'm pretty sure when you ask people, nobody has seen where he went after that. Like, nobody will tell you that they know where he is.
I thought there were pictures of Nathan doing some place where she was buried.
Yeah, there was a picture of them laying down.
Yeah.
Like, there were a picture of both of them on the ground in the junkyard, and to me, they both looked fucked up.
Yeah.
She might be dead, he might be completely drugged. Who knows?
Okay.
Like, the problem with that is don't they get led to that spot by, like, information that's backdated from when Rachel disappeared?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that would be weird that Nathan would be there, because Nathan...
There's multiple locations, though, because there's different vehicles that were being tracked.
Jefferson's car is one of the vehicles you can see when you're putting out clues.
Yep.
Which means that David was tracking him, because those are David's photos that you got of the cars.
I don't know.
So it's gonna be David coming to save me.
Why was he's not gonna save me? I'm fucked. Why did
I
do that?
Yeah, but he's tracking him, and then he drove to the bunker.
Save, like, he's not. I don't think
episode 5 happens. Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, he's not gonna be like, this teenage girl was mean to me. I'm not gonna stop this killer.
I think.
Yeah. Too bad you had a chance. My game is just over. It's like, nope, you're done.
You shouldn't have blamed me. You should have blamed me. Now you're dead.
They've given him enough humanity where he'll do it anyway, I think. Like, they didn't make him a total asshole.
I hope so.
Especially
and
if
then
he
I can
knows
apologize.
You know what would be even worse, though, is if, like, yeah, he's gonna save the day no matter what, but depending whether or not, like, you side with him, he lives or dies through it.
That might be it.
Sure. I can see that.
Which is even worse, because the person, you killed the person that just saved you by not, like, being nice.
Wait, I just thought of something, and maybe they said this. When you go to the alternate timeline where Chloe's handicapped, did they talk about Rachel at all?
Yeah, you say, do you know the name Rachel? And she's like, no.
She didn't know who she was, right?
Yeah, because she...
Were there posters about her in that alternate timeline? I can't remember. Like, was she still missing, or was she just didn't exist?
No, she was missing.
Yeah.
She was.
She's like, oh, that... Like, Rachel?
That's what I
thought. Oh, yeah,
that's
right.
What I thought.
Like, oh, you know her name.
You could talk to the mother about her as well, I think.
I didn't even see the mother. I totally missed that.
She's in the bedroom.
She's in the bedroom.
Both of them. I think you can say you can mention it to both of the parents.
Why? What kind of coincidence would it take for her to be missing in both timelines? Is the thing.
Murder.
Yeah, murder that has nothing to do with Chloe for some reason, because her scenario didn't change it.
Timelines.
Well, isn't that a little bit strange? Because usually everything changes on an alternate universe, even just a little.
Well, what, if Mr. Jefferson is doing that, why would he not do that in a different timeline?
I guess that's true.
If she's going to that school or whatever.
Fucking Mr. Jefferson.
I'm going to meet a Mr. Jefferson someday and just like... Son of a bitch.
It's even more annoying because, like, if you go through the first episode again and you're walking through, like, outside of the school where the photos are that he's taken, they're creepy. You realize that they're actually the creepy photos, just not, like, of drugged girls, but they're still the black and white, like, girls being basically probably forced to pose.
So, Nathan is, like... shown to be mentally unstable, and there's all those scribblings and stuff. What if Mr. Jefferson is doing something to him?
Like, well, you mean other than feeding him with drugs all the time? I'm sure.
Yeah, I was gonna say, like, what if he's pumping him full of shit to make him like that?
Well, I'm sure
him that way to get to his family.
It seems like he's.
Their family doesn't know, though.
I think Nathan has always had probably some mental issues, and sure. I think Jefferson is probably just mentoring him and making it 10 times worse on purpose, right? He's like, because he's weak.
I think he might be blackmailing him, maybe that too. Because there's that picture that he took of them, of him and the murder victim together, and he's like, so the last time this girl was seen, you were laying beside her in like a dank pit with a bunch of needles around you. What do you think they're gonna say? Like, maybe he's black.
I think that's why they had to kill Rachel, because she was awake too long. She knew what was going on. She knew what was going to happen. She would have told the minute she got out of that situation.
And then they drugged Nathan to have a patsy to take the fall in case shit happens.
But I also think Nathan's looking up to Mr. Jefferson and wants to please him, probably because of his own relationship with his father. It seems like that's what they're working up to. I don't know. He's just in a bad place and needs, like, some kind of mentor figure, even though he knows it's bad.
Did you look at the photos in Nathan's room, in his dorm room?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That one of Chloe?
No. I meant, like, his actual, like...
Like, the whales on the beach in black and white and stuff?
Yeah.
I thought that was a cool photo, actually.
And what about the whale sounds and stuff? Is it related, or is it just not related?
I kind of hate how they're really, like, walking around the issue at every point, like, I don't know what's going on with nature, but something's happening, but there's like zero explanation of how.
I can't help but think it's related to the Prescott somehow, but how could it be?
Or just related to time travel in general.
That's what I was thinking, yeah.
Because, like, yeah, the stuff starts happening after you time travel, but this is something anytime time travel comes into play in any media now, I just think of that video you showed me, Peter, with the, with, like, talking about dimensions and stuff.
Oh,
like,
yeah, the 12 dimensions.
How fourth dimension is time, and the fifth dimension is, like, time is a physical thing. That and part
time
of
time along a 2D plane.
Yeah. And then how, like, in some of Arthur C. Clarke's work, he talks about how time is... We think of time as, like, going in kind of one way, but it's kind of just a space of stuff and circular. So maybe stuff started happening because time travel was going to happen, and that just fucks with everything along the past, present, and future.
So, like, multiple people time traveling across the world.
Yeah, or even just the one might be enough, but yeah, that would be it too. If, like, other stuff comes into play or you find out other people are time traveling.
I still want some sort of explanation as to how it connects to nature.
I mean, I feel like they're going to give us that.
You can't just throw out two moons, some birds are dying, here's, like, a giant tornado that's getting bigger with, like, every time we cut to it, but nobody can see it. So, yeah, don't worry about it. But it's imminent. Just don't worry about it. You can't be throwing around the nature stuff, and then it seems too disconnected from everything else that's going on.
You
can't throw it out like, oh, you should be worried about this. No, I'm not worried about it, because you haven't given me any reason to worry about it.
It makes me want to subscribe a little bit more to the theory that Max is actually just, like, dying, and it's her brain short-circuiting as she's, like, trying to deal with stuff in her mind. I kind of hope they don't do that. I hope they don't do that way. Actually, it's kind of lazy writing.
I hadn't ever made this connection before, but there's a movie called Another Earth, and the main plot line involves this girl who was drunk driving and killed this entire family, and then later finds out that the dad/husband was alive and is talking to him. But as a backdrop to the entire movie, another Earth, like a planet identical to Earth in every way, including our cities and people, is discovered, like, just appears close by, close enough to travel to. And at the end, everything, like, they don't really mention it a whole lot, except in the background, and you hear people talking about it occasionally, and everything in the end kind of tied in really nicely to that, and I wonder if that's going to happen here. Like, people kind of mention that, you know, everything is getting fucked up, but I think in the end it will not necessarily play a huge role, but it will play a role that ties in really nicely, I hope.
Yeah, like, maybe instead of thinking about it like time travel where Max is jumping around, maybe this is all like five different Max, like, trans-dimensional stuff going on where we're like taking up consciousness within the different versions of herself or something, where like on this one dimensional plane or whatever, it's the beginning of the game, and then when she like goes back or whatever to another time, that's actually like another thing that's playing out, and they're all playing out at the same time.
It kind of goes back to like a fifth dimensional being.
The credence behind that is she wears a deer like t-shirts all the time.
Yeah.
Mm. It kind of goes back to that video that Ben was talking about, the dimensions thing, because the further on you go, it's like seventh or eighth dimension, something stupid, but essentially you're left with an infinite amount of dimensions with different variations. It could be slight, they could be major, and they're all happening at the same time, and they're all moving forward. So if she's jumping between, like, you see how you rewind and then you make a change and do something else?
Yeah.
That's going back on the path and then going down a different dimension.
And then, like, during the Kate suicide thing, like, there's a bunch of different ways that can pan out, but no matter what, you can't use your powers because the way she deals with that situation is the same in every, different version of that event happening.
Right.
My head is hurting.
Dimension stuff is fucked up.
It's too much. What we're saying, if you actually upload this anywhere and people are listening to this, is play the goddamn game. Please.
It's so good.
Like, why wouldn't you at this point?
Actually, I'm really glad, Paul, that you hopped onto this game, because...
Cut out.
Yeah, that Peter kind of mentioned that you're not really into games like this a lot, but you were playing this one and it was good. I just bought it.
Just like instantly, it's like, wait a minute. Like, oh, Paul likes a game with a story in it? It must be a good story. I'm in.
I'm just buying it. I'm just going in. And it was a good decision.
It's too good. Horrible, Square good Enix needs to do more shit like this.
Well, aren't they just publishing it?
Yeah, they need to put more money behind shit like this.
Yeah. Well, one of their next games, I don't think there's any gameplay or trailers or anything, but it was talked about a little at E3, is like, it's called like Setsuna or something like that, and it's going to be an RPG, and all that they've said about it is that the theme of the game is sadness, and that makes me interested now.
Doesn't Warren have the photo that everybody thinks is going to save her? He said he was keeping it for posterity, or am I wrong?
Yeah.
You might be right, actually, yeah.
Alright, she's fucked. I'm sorry! Just going through and thinking about it. Ugh.
I think
I'm gonna spend the next month reading the subreddit.
Yeah, I think the image she took of herself looking at her wall of photos is going to be, like, significantly important.
You think they're going to pull, like, an X-Men and go, like, all the way back? Like, so far back that...
Maybe that's not important to the gameplay, but to just, like, understanding this whole, like, transdimensional thing, like, that theory that there's a bunch of different things happening. She can kind of see all of them at one time, like, looking at photos on a wall.
Huh. See that happening.
My head is, like, ready to fucking explode. I'm glad I
took
some.
One more thing. I've actually got to go soon, but one more thing I'm going to leave you with. And yeah. The final cutscene... when mm-hmm. Chloe gets shot and it's in slow motion and they're zooming in on her and they zoom in on her bullet necklace and it shows three bullets.
The
Do you remember
times
that?
She almost died.
Yeah, she's been shot three times through the whole game.
She was only shot twice in mine.
Nope.
When was the third
time? It's dependent on choice, yeah. Well, she's shot by Nathan
yep.
in the first episode. Shot by herself in episode two because when you're in the... when you're in the graveyard, she has a possibility to shoot a sign and ricochet it off herself. That actually happened to me.
Oh, I've never
until
done
I rewound
that.
It. Yeah, you can do it.
Oh, okay.
And then you rewind and tell her to shoot somewhere else, and then Jefferson shoots her. So there is the three possible times that she can get shot.
Oh. So like maybe third time's a charm, sort of thing.
Maybe.
Like that's a death that you can't save.
I'm wondering, because the first two you can rewind right away. I'm wondering if the third one you can't rewind, and that's what I'm worried about. Like, third time's it, or something.
Three strikes, you're out?
Because she's already been dragged back to the dark room, right? We've seen it. So yeah. We know that some time has already passed, and Chloe's laying there dead, right?
Yeah.
I was kind of interested in why he went to go and drug Max and then shoot Chloe. So like
if
first
knew.
Off he has to have first off
yeah
there was that. Like maybe he knew about the time travel thing, but if not, he sort of has to have a reason to hold on to Max.
I think see my theory on that is just sort of the Occam's razor, like simplest explanation, in that Max
she
was
closer to him.
Max was closer,
yeah, but he had drugs
already,
on him,
but he yes, because he already had pictures of Chloe. Why the hell would he want a duplicate binder?
He didn't
Max
have pictures of
have
Chloe. Nathan did.
Yeah, he did, didn't he? Yeah.
No, Nathan had it.
Doesn't he what probably have access notes? To those pictures?
Chloe, yeah, Chloe like, has no folder. No, I think Nathan did that on his own because of Jefferson's influence.
On his own.
Like,
I guess
as initiation or something, maybe?
Yeah, I think that's what it was. That's why she was so pissed at him in the beginning, because of what he did. She was threatening to tell.
You're right.
School
I forgot about
that. That's what he did.
Well, I guess he know. Like, I don't know.
I mean, you could say that the reason they're
Chloe,
the ones Nathan did are still alive.
Shot her instead of bothering with whatever. But Max was one of his students, and he knows her more so.
I think the only one that's died is Rachel. Morbid. I think all the other girls in those binders are still alive.
I kind of agree with you on that one.
Yeah. I hope so. Otherwise, that's like
I don't because I want to. I want to meet Rachel in this game at some.
I
point.
Do too. I hope I get to. Oh my god, I really do. Good talk though. If you guys ever want to talk about this crap later, hook me up. Let
Definitely.
Me know.
Definitely, we're gonna have to do something for the last one because goddamn, it's gonna be.
Oh yeah. Joke.
Yeah. Holy shit.
Now to try to not go play the game and get David back until a month from now. Jesus.
Probably more like 2 months.